Ladies and gentlemen, here to talk about my days at the White House is Stephen Roshan.
Now, turn me on. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Ms. Stribling. And this is a tough act. After all of these great minds, these STEM innovative people, these techies, and then you bring this old retired admiral up here. To follow these great minds is really something else. And I take my hat off to all of you up here that did such a wonderful job. I was brought in by Dr. Taborn at the tail end to talk about something just a little bit lighter. But because of what he did to me to follow these wonderful people with these great technical minds, I'm going to expose something. A little bird told me just a few minutes ago by the name of Major General Ron Johnson, that today is Dr. Taborn's birthday. Happy birthday, Dr. Taborn. Okay. So I'm here to talk a little bit about some little known facts and things that are behind the scenes. And one thing I will start off preface that was to say that we don't talk politics in the permanent staff in the White House. So you're not gonna get any of that tonight. You're gonna break from politics, and we're just gonna talk about the good things in this beautiful place at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. It all started in this little White House at 1219 Hillary Street in New Orleans, Louisiana. We moved there when I was 3 years old, and it ended up at this big White House at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. I was about ready to call it quits. I'd served my 36 years in uniform. I served my time at Customs and Border Protection, and now it was time to go back to New Orleans, sit on my front porch, and eat a shrimp po' boy sandwich and just really enjoy life. But then I got this call from this house here, presidential personnel, that wanted to ask if I would consider coming to the White House to be the chief usher. And I says, what in the heck is a chief usher? I spent all these years in federal service, and I'm going to go and be a usher in a movie house. Well, little did I know that it wasn't quite like that. And so I went through 9 interviews. My last interview was in the Oval Office with President George W. Bush. And we sat down in the Oval Office, and we talked a little bit, and he was nodding. And he says, really strange question. He says, Admiral, how's your marriage? Yeah, my dear bride is on the front row here. And I said, Mr. President, I have the best marriage in the world, second to yours. And he really liked that. He smiled. And I picked up these tips when I was standing at these big black gates on Pennsylvania Avenue, getting a little nervous because I'm going in to speak to the President of the United States. And I thought about a couple of mentors. Norm Mineta was one of them, the Department of Transportation Secretary. And he said, Steve, just be yourself. And I said, okay, I can do that. So the President nodded his head at that. And then he says, what do you think about this chief usher business? And I said, well, Mr. President, what's in the title? I'm just thrilled that I've gotten to the point now, my 9th interview, that I just might have a chance to work for the President of the United States. So he liked that. The next day, I was called into the personnel office, and they told me, one, you have the job, but the President wants you to change the title for the first time in history since the 1800s. And so I thought about it a little bit, and I called them back, and I says, let's change it to Director of the Executive Residence. And then a historian said, and Chief Usher. So I couldn't get rid of that. But it was a real pleasure to work for the President and First Lady. This lady, little people don't know, little do you know that behind the scenes, she ran that house. And the most delightful person that you ever want to meet. And it was a real joy to meet with them. So let me take you on a quick tour in these little 10 minutes. That's going to be tough. I'm going to take you through a quick tour. It's beginning with my little office on the mezzanine level on the north portico of the White House. This is the, you may have seen this. Anyone's been on a tour of the house? This is the entrance hall. And right up in the corner above those double doors, you see that little peephole up there? That's my office. So I was able to look down on the floor to see what was going on, but I covered it up because I didn't think that was a nice thing to do. This is the cross hall right next to the entrance hall. This is the cross hall dressed up Christmas time. Each First Lady has their own taste, and even this year we had a chance to look at it, and it was quite beautiful. This is the state dining room. Right now it wasn't set up here in this picture for the major state dinners they had, but that's the state dining room. This is the green room, one of the reception rooms. I'm standing next to one of my most favorite butlers, Mr. Ramsey, who is no longer with us. This is the blue room, one of the main rooms or attractions in the center of the White House. And I'll tell you something about behind that window, behind that plant a little bit later on, which is actually a heavy-duty glass security door that leads to the South Lawn. This is the red room, and this is the east room where we have all the major events, whether there's going to be a talk or some major production or entertainment, such as Stevie Wonder. This is on the second level. A lot of people don't see this, but it's on the second level, which is the private second floor of the White House. This is the Lincoln bedroom. It was one of my favorite places to walk through because I was able to actually stand there and read the original signed Gettysburg Address by Abraham Lincoln. And here's my incredible staff. Over 95 full-time staff members and about 250 part-time staff to take care of the White House. That was over 100,000 square feet. They consisted of the butlers, the carpenters, the engineers, some engineers in my background, the chefs, the pastry chefs, you name it. We had everyone that had their own jobs, the engineers in the basement, of course, but the plumbers were outstanding, the carpenters, really a well-experienced trained crew. This is one of the housekeepers getting ready for the inauguration. These are my great butlers, distinguished gentlemen, and they had their little fun times on the side that I can't share all of them, but in fact, this is one of them. This is on the second floor in the West Sitting Hall, right outside the President's master bedroom. And we did have our little side jokes that I can't repeat. Sometimes we needed Mickey Mouse to come help us out. And another one of my very favorite butlers from Haiti, Smiley Saint-Aubin, who is no longer with us, unfortunately, and one of our part-time staff serving from the kitchen to the state dining room. Down in the basement is where the chef does her wonderful work. This is our executive chef, Chris Comerford, and this is her again set up in the state dining room. for reception, not for the actual dinner. And these are the ones, my right hand folks, the ushers, the assistant ushers that took care of the daily. Some of the military would understand. They stood to watch when I was not there. One of the things that was most memorable shortly after I got there was to have my first state dinner. And the state dinners, as I mentioned before, are for heads of state. And they roll out the red carpet, literally. And this one was for Her Majesty the Queen of England. And she wanted to meet myself and my deputy chief usher to thank us for doing such a job to honor her presence. So because of that, she sent an invitation and invited me to Buckingham Palace to see how the Brits do it. I brought my lovely bride, Shirley, and my first butler, the chef, and a couple other my staff. And not only did we take a tour and enjoy Buckingham Palace, but the Queen invited us to the Queen's diplomatic reception, black tie event. And someone told me, we're going to put you in the last room, the sitting room, the sitting hall, because the Queen has to pass by you to get to her quarters. And I said, oh, that's nice. So sure enough, Her Majesty, after waving to everyone as she was coming through the house, she walks up to me and she says, and who are you, young man? And I says, Your Majesty, I'm Admiral Rashawn, the Director of Executive Residence. And she yells back, Philip, come meet the Admiral. That was pretty neat to have that much so attention. And she shook Shirley's hand and everyone else, a delightful lady. I had a chance to fly on Air Force One with the President. This one event was to go to Camp David with him to help put on another event to make sure it went as well as we did it in the mansion. One of my favorite visits was Pope Benedict. And it was one of my favorites because they told me that I could not be in a room at the same time. The staff told me, no, we don't want you in there. It's just a president and first lady. I said, you know, I'm a chief usher. Why can't I be in a room with the Pope? And it says, nope, clear the room and whatever. But what they didn't know is a little secret, that door behind that I mentioned to you before, that glass door, that great big ballistic door, opens up to where the Pope had to come in. And I'm the only one that has the key. So although I couldn't pose with the Pope, the photographer, who was a friend of mine, I just called, he took a picture of me behind the Pope. And because the Pope was so thrilled with his treatment at the White House, he gave me one of Pope Benedict's coin, a challenge coin that most of you in the military here are familiar with. And this is one of the final pictures with my dear mom, my dear wife, with the Bushes, one of our last times in the White House with that administration. One of the other fun things to do, sort of lighthearted, was I was in charge of picking out the White House Christmas tree every year. Had to be 18 feet tall to fit into the blue room. And this is just some of my Park Service folks assisting me. The biggest thrill for me, to be honest with you, was President and Mrs. Bush wanted me to be the first one to greet the first African-American president to the White House. This was President-elect Barack Obama and Mrs. Obama in the diplomatic reception room. That was something else. This is a picture of them going to the inauguration. And I put this up because the next picture was probably one of the hardest jobs, because the moment that the outgoing president and incoming president catch the limousines to the Capitol for the inauguration, my staff, they can't touch the house before that. In 5 hours, doing the inauguration, the parade, and all that, we have to move out the old president and outgoing president and their belongings and move in the new president and all of their belongings. 5 hours. One truck facing this side, the west, the other one, west, the one facing the east. And by the time the new president, Barack Obama and Mrs. Obama, comes through the diplomatic reception room, everything is in place, including new wallpaper and painting and the kids' rooms with new chandeliers. I mean, everything was done. Incredible staff. Even my grandkids, little Remy and my dear little grandson, Landry, watching their papa on TV talk about the inauguration. This is a quick little story about my dear little wife who, this is right after the Obamas came into the White House. They were coming down for an event. My wife and I had to go to another important event, so I was gonna leave my assistant ushers to take care of business. And I says, look, honey, the president and first lady are coming down the elevator. Why don't you stand at the usher's door and you can take a look at the first African-American president of the United States. My wife is pretty shy, and she says, no, I'm going to stay in the office because I just can't do that. Elevator came down. President came. Hi, Elmer, how are you doing? Mr. President, you have a moment? I want you to meet somebody. And I whispered. So he says, sure, Admiral. We walk into the usher's office. My wife nearly passed out. Of course, I thought I was going to get divorce papers after that, too. But he came in. I said, Mr. President, this is my wife, Shirley. And he gave her a kiss on the cheek. And man, Michelle, come in here and meet the Admiral's wife. So she has yet to forgive me about that. One of the other big thrills of my life, and I did it for both presidents, is to walk the president every single morning from the executive residence, the big mansion you see in those pictures, to the West Wing. And this was one of our daily walks with the president over there. We had some talks, some that I can't discuss. He's quite a hilarious guy. But his main topic every day was, Admiral, how's my hoops coming? He wanted some new basketball hoops. And every day he bugged me about those hoops. And finally, when they came in from Spalding, and I had him paint the White House on the base, I converted the tennis court, existing tennis court, to a basketball tennis court with different color lines. And I said, Mr. President, your hoops are coming at 11 o'clock this morning. And his eyes lit up. At 10:45, he came out, and he could not stop. He was playing with the hoops and dunking, and this man was like a kid enjoying popping strings every single time. This was showing the first lovely, adorable first daughters pictures of different swing sets, because my next concentration was to take care of them. And here's the product from Rainbow Play Systems. I flew all the way to South Dakota to pick out this particular play set for the Obama daughters. Rainbow was so pleased with saying they built a play set for the White House that they built this table, and they, on the top they put all the different presidents' brass plates embedded on the top, and then my little name on the base of the picnic table. When I left, I was given that to take for a souvenir. Met some really great people, Oprah, and we became friends after this. I may tell you about it a little bit later, and my time is really running out. The two Stevies together, Stevie Roshan and Stevie Wonder. What a nice guy. He came back to the house a few times, and Whoopi. She was roaming through the house after the event, lost because the East Wing staff had kind of like left her behind. So I escorted her to her car out on 17th Street And as a result, oh, it's not in here, but she sent me a nice little, well, no, she did. She sent me that that thank you photo. Of course, Sugar Ray Leonard, neat guy. And Maya Angelou, when she came to get her medal from the president, she too, in a wheelchair, was left hanging and didn't know how to get out the house. And I always walked around. And so I saw her and I rolled her out. And she stopped and she asked, she says, young man, give me your address. She said, because I can't thank you enough for what you did for me. So she sent me a little thank you note. Nancy Reagan, Bill Clinton, President Bill Clinton, Reverend Billy Graham, even Jack Hanna, the animal trainer. So, and these are just a fraction of the great people. Taking Meryl Streep on a tour of the White House. And the president was really excited to plant the Obama tree. There was, in that same place, a George Bush tree, but it didn't last. So President Obama was happy to do this tree, and it's still there. Surprise, surprise. Oh, I said no politics, right? And this is one of our final Christmas photos with this dear first family. My last day at the White House was pretty difficult for me. The president wanted me to come to the Oval Office to spend some time to thank me for my time with him. And this is a photo of that last event. So it was a very incredible 4 years, with 2 years with each president. It was all over. I took on a position, a SES position at Customs and Border Protection. And then it was time for me to say, let's give time to the family. I thought I was going to rest. And then I get this call from the producer, Pam Williams from California, wanted me to consult on a movie called The Butler. This is the real butler, Charles Allen, with Forrest Whitaker behind him. He actually passed away before the movie was done. And then here's part of the movie with Whitaker and Clarence William III, and you can see a few other folks back there. Cooper Gooding Jr. in the back, and Dwight D. Eisenhower, played by Robin Williams. And the two of us had some real nice quiet moments because he wanted to learn how to be a butler. And Oprah, she was also in a movie. She came late one day when we were doing the formal event. And all I can hear in the background is, where's my admiral? And I beamed, of course, and she wanted to take this little selfie with us. I even had my son in the background playing a White House chef. And he really appreciated that and getting close to Forrest Whitaker. I'll end with this picture. I don't know if you all recognize Alex Haley, the author of the famous book, Roots. He spent 20 years in Coast Guard uniform. A lot of people don't realize that, but he was our first journalist in the Coast Guard. And he became my mentor and friend before he passed away. And so I will leave you all with words that are inscribed on the back of my challenge coin, my White House challenge coin. This is, find the good and praise it. And I'm looking out in this room at all these wonderful STEM folks here in the audience, and I find the good right here in this room. And I wish to thank all of you for being who you are and what you do for this great country of ours. Thank you.